At the state dinner for President Emmanuel Macron last year, the White House served American wine made from French grapes. A year later, the White House has imposed a 25% tariff on French wine made from French grapes.
I've always liked American wines better than French wines, even though I don't drink wine.
The tariff has nothing to do with any agricultural tensions between France and the U.S. The dispute was over the EU's subsidies for Airbus, which the World Trade Organization recently said had harmed U.S.-based Boeing's bottom line. To make things right, the WTO says the U.S. can impose $7.5 billion in tariffs on EU goods, including wine. That's an expensive surprise for small U.S. business owners, such as New York wine merchant Heather Johnston.
I'm going to have a 25% increase on a significant amount of my wines. So all I can hope now is to just remain steady. Growth in this scenario is unlikely at best.
It's not just French, Spanish, and German wines facing a 25% tariff. Lovers of Spanish olive oil will be paying more. So too will those buying cheeses and meats, butter and yogurt, even some housewares and small tools. Oh, and aircraft parts? The U.S. is taxing them at just 10%.
And frankly, I'm concerned that there's not a lot of preparation because there simply wasn't time. And so I'm affected. The Italian butcher across the street who sells Parmesan cheese is affected. The restaurants, the whole food and wine gamut.
European producers had been fearing the worst, even lobbying Secretary of State Mike Pompeo to intervene during his recent trip to Rome. But while some EU countries say they should retaliate by imposing tariffs of their own, others say they have to respect the WTO's decision.
So WTO has given now a decision which is, well, quite tough with Europe. But I just say that the WTO has said its opinion, and that's that.
Heather Johnston says she's now reworking her business plan.
I enjoy sharing food and wine. It's like something that makes people happy.
But she's very much aware there is a limit to how much people will pay for their happiness. Rosalind Jordan, Al Jazeera, Washington.